Hey everyone, it's Monica with Scrapping for My Boys, and I'm finally back with another project share. For today, I actually have a collab that I am going to be featuring. This is going to be for the Christmas Cheer 2021 collab. This is an all-year collab hosted by Poet Spice here on YouTube. There are about, I want to say, 6 or 7 of us in the collab. All of the ladies' information will be in the description box below. Please be sure to head over to their channels and watch their videos and give them some support. A little bit of information about the collab. We post every second Friday of every single month at 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time or 7 Pacific. And like I said, it is an all-year collab that is Christmas themed, so we can create anything that we want as long as it is Christmas related. I think that is about it. There is a hashtag if you want to go ahead and follow along. You can either do a video or you can post on Instagram, but the hashtag is going to be Poet Spice Collabs 2021. It will be in the description box below as well. Okay, so very quickly, let me go ahead and show you the products that I used. I used my Paper Tray Ink Wine Bottle Tag number 2. I used a Cherry Lynn Designs die. This is the poinsettia strip, old school die. Cherry Lynn, like I mentioned, doesn't exist anymore. They rebranded, new company, completely different route. I don't think you can find this anymore, but you can always search eBay. See, some older stores still carry Cherry Lynn products because they have old inventory. This is also a Cherry Lynn's die, but I broke the original pocket that it was in, so I don't have the part number on it. I had just been too lazy to go ahead and add it, but I actually have 3 of the dies, and it's a holly leaf strip, and it gives you 3 different sizes, so I use that. And that is essentially it as far as dies are concerned. All right, let's go ahead and get into our project. So I decided to do wine bottle tags from the saw on the, right now when I show you the dice. So here are the wine bottle tags that I created. I've been super busy. I didn't have time to work on something super involved for my project. So I kind of took the simple route. I am in 2 swaps that I joined back to back. So that's what's been occupying my time. But I still love the way these turned out. So 2 different tags, 1 in black and 1 in white. Here's where you see the poinsettia. On this one, I used 2 layers of the largest flower, 1 of the next size down, and 1 of the smallest. On this one here, I used 2 of the larger petal and 2 of the middle petal. I did not use the smallest petal in the flower. This stamp here is actually a Jaded Blossom stamp set, and I'm drawing a blank on what it is. I will put, if I can find it, I don't know where my package is. I had it and I threw it off to the side. If I have it, I'll either put it on the screen or I'll put it in the description box below. I colored it with my Spectrum Noir markers. I'm not a big colorer anymore, so you don't really see me coloring too much on my channel. But I do still love to color, and I'll do small items like this. So on this one, I used glitz paper for the background. The center of the flower that's an SS30 light Colorado topaz glass flatback rhinestones. The ones on the various corners are SS16s. For this die, it does not come with this matting layer. So what I always do, because I'm a person that loves to mat, I will essentially run the die up until this point, and then I will just trim it out so I can have a matting layer. This is all done out of 110-pound cardstock, except this green one. This green one is, it's 100-pound. What's the company? It is, let me look behind me. It is Poptone. But this color is also the same as the Paper Tray Ink Pine Feathers, exact same color. The little tag I colored, it is popped up on thin dimensionals, which is kind of difficult to tell unless you're looking at it. And I, you know, turned it off to the side just to give it a different look. And like for the rhinestones, I just followed the border along. So here is a close-up. The flower makes a super dimensional, but the inner sentiment is not popped up very high. It's pretty thin. So here is this one here. For the black one, I essentially did the same thing, except I turned it to the other side and I put the flower on the other corner. I used different rhinestones. This is gold shimmer cardstock from Michaels. This is 65 pound. I'm not a 65 pound girl. I don't roll with 65 pound paper. So I did do two layers to double it up to get thicker cardstock. I don't like lightweight cardstock. I need heavyweight. 100 pound or above is my go-to. Unless whatever project I'm working on, 100 pound or 110 doesn't work with the creasing, I'll scale it back to like 80 pound. But for the most part, I roll with 100 or 110 for everything. The only other difference I did this with this one is the flag that comes with a die. And goodness gracious, what did I just do with the die? I had it, and I moved it off. Oh, there they are. Okay. The die itself comes with a banner, so I cut this out, and I just shortened the flags, and I just used the ends of it and tucked them in behind the tag. Nothing fancy, but again, that is what it looks like. On this one, I use clear glass flatback rhinestones. These are, again, SS16s, as well as the center, and this one is an SS16 because I have the metal stamen in the center. But that is essentially it for my two bottle tags. I do create a lot of wine bottle tags. For those of you who are not familiar, I actually work for a winery, so I'm constantly getting wine, and I gift a lot of wine as well. So, though I'm not a huge wine drinker, I'm getting used to it, but I have tons of wine because I get it from work. But yeah, this is it. If you have any questions, comment below. Again, please go check out all the other ladies in the collab and go give them some support and some love. I believe some of the ladies might be doing a giveaway. I'm not 100% sure. It is up to the discretion of each individual channel if they want to go ahead and host a collab. Host a giveaway. I still haven't decided if I want to go ahead and do one. I probably will. I don't know if I'll pick a random video to do a giveaway on, or if I'm going to do it at the end of the collab. Who knows? But be sure to watch every video, comment, like, all of that good stuff. And I will also be checking to see if you participated in the other ladies' videos, commenting and such. But again, I'll bring that up whenever I decide to go ahead and do it. But just to let you know that some of the ladies might be doing giveaways. Alrighty, I'm going to quit rambling because I talk a lot. I'm going to get out of here. So I'll catch you guys in the next video. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.